We were beaming with enthusiasm. There was a lot of, you know, positive anxiety. The flame was already on the streets of Vancouver. It was when I got the first phone call, we started these practices. And then when the phone rang, Dave said, you know, John, I, you know, really bad news. And he said, this athlete from Georgia has come off the track and he's been critically injured and he's not likely to survive. And I put the phone down and I actually thought that the next phone call was going to be, he's okay. I just thought, you know, he'll call me back and I'll never forget it, you know. It must have been 15 minutes, and he said, John, I'm sorry to tell you that Nodar Kumaritashvili is dead. We had the opening ceremonies. It was incredibly difficult. I was pretty actually scared because everyone was watching, and the standard would have to be extremely appropriate. And so I was worried about not doing a good job, not doing it properly, not saying it the right way, and probably the harshest critics are ourselves. I mean, it's not something I'm ever going to get over, I don't think. I was looking at a photograph this morning of his dad was holding up this picture of his son holding the Olympic torch, which he had sent him from here when he had arrived. And when we got there and to their home, and there's this small little house, and Nodar's room was in the attic. And to get to his room, you have to climb up sort of a ladder stairway at the back of the house. And there above his bed, they had taken the picture and turned it into a poster of him holding that torch. And then all over his bed were postcards and paraphernalia and stuff, some of which we brought, and stuff that had been sent to the family from mostly Canadians, telling them how, you know, awful we felt, and just providing them with encouragement and empathy and sympathy. It was very touching.